Do you agree with me? If yes, then you are supposed to put a mark somewhere. After 7:30 or 8 p.m., you check your mobile only once in every hour. See if there are urgencies or emergencies. Otherwise, you have to settle down within. Cool down your mind, which is heated up right from morning 8 a.m. You have to cool it down, give it time. Otherwise, you can be a big loser. Because now we are getting more used to friends on Facebook and social media than real-time friends. Agree? A work-life balance. I suggest a very good 30-second speech for everybody of you, since you all are professionals. It is on the YouTube. The 30-second speech made by Brian Dyson, the ex-world CEO of Coca-Cola. He was at a convention somewhere and he has made a speech, just 30 seconds. I would elaborate it a bit for the proper understanding of everybody. He said that after 40 years into the corporate world at the topmost levels, you will come to know certain things, a particular fact, and that is, actually in life you are juggling with 5 balls. The first sentence that he said. Then he elaborates the second sentence. The 5 sentence, the 5 balls are: first ball is the ball of work, second ball is the work of family, third ball is the ball of friends and social interactions, fourth is health, and fifth is spirit. I repeat: work, family, friends, health, and spirit. You are juggling with these 5 balls. You have seen the circus of Joker juggling with many balls? In the same way, you are juggling with these 5 balls in your life. Then he goes, then after 40 years into the professional career, you will come to know that the first ball, that is the ball of work, is made up of rubber and the rest 4 balls are made up of glass. The first ball, that is the ball of work, it is made up of rubber. And the other 4 balls are made up of glass. Now, if you lose from your hand the ball of rubber, it will bounce back. A rubber ball bounces back. That means you will get a work opportunity again. As Richard Branson of Virgin, he says in his autobiography, that work is like bus station. A bus comes every 3 minutes. Work is like, opportunities are like, bus station here, a bus comes every 3 minutes. You will get a second opportunity to work. Maybe a bit of a layoff, but you will get a second opportunity to work. And you can equally perform and exhibit. But the other 4 balls, the ball of family, friends, health, and spirit, they are made up of glass. Once you lose, it falls on the floor. If not broken, it will get cracked. If not cracked, it will at least get dishes. Right or wrong? Then he says, so get to work on time, work very effectively during your working hours, and get back to your family on time. And then he said, thank you for listening to me. This was his very last advice. Get to work on time, work very effectively during your working hours, and get back to your family on time. It's a fine 40-second speech on the YouTube. You can put Brian Dyson and you can get this speech. Worth listening. See, people at this level, they have maintained work-life balance. They have been successful in maintaining it. If we try at our levels, we can. About a couple of years back, I was in Jaipur at a medical conference. We had about 800 physicians, and you might have heard the name of Shiv Khera. He's a motivational speaker. We two were sitting on the dais together. We both were supposed to conduct the whole seminar. And we were discussing this particular point. And I asked Shiv Khera that how many people you have come across in your life, you are a professional trainer, who have been really able to maintain work-life balance And he gave me a wonderful answer. And I asked him that you put this answer on my message. And he did. And he said, after all his experience, that those people, those professionals who really wanted a work-life balance did make to it. If you're not able to do it, you're not intended to do it. And if you intend, you can definitely do it. A very fine analysis from all his experience. So proper work-life balance. 9 to 6 you are a businessman, and 6 to 9 you are a family man. If you don't remember any other thing from the talk, the second is, remember one thing, 9 to 6 and 6 to 9, and you can have a wonderful balanced life, because your family is a divine unit. It is not by accident that you all come together as husband, wife and children. It was divinely designed. It is not an accident. You have to take care of your family equally. Now again a question you that could arise in your mind, that you are again hearing this from a person who doesn't have a family. You are not married and we don't have wife and children. So you must have this question in mind, how this person is going to talk on family values. But we conduct seminars and conferences and on family issues, family values and virtues at many places. We and Atul Ajmera, we went together in 1996. We conducted a seminar in New York. Atul Bhai and we went together. Atul Bhai Yachar. And Bowen Street, New York. In 1996, we were there. We were conducting a seminar on family values. We used to have group discussions with children of different age group. We used to have talks with the in group discussions and exchange with the parents. And as part of the curriculum that we had designed, we had designed a form where we asked the children, somewhere in the age group of 8, 10, somewhere in the 12, 14 range, that what do you like about your parents and what you don't like about the parents. You got it? And we had all these group discussions. And you would be surprised. Some 8, 10, 12 year old kids, they have written something that is an eye-opener, alarming. An 8-year-old boy had written that I don't like my father not joining us at dinner. Now he's not able to express because he's a small kid, or maybe he would not talk just in front of his father, but he gets out. Then he goes, another one kid, he writes that I don't like my parents fighting with each other in my presence. Work-life balance contains all these virtues. Whatever the hell has happened in your office, don't carry it back in your home. And don't fight with your spouse or pour that anger on your children because just he has not completed his small homework and you didn't complete your projects. You didn't complete your projects, you got angry and frustrated because of the scolding from your boss, and you are pouring that anger on that small little child because just he did not complete his small homework of 15 minutes. You don't have the right. This is not a work-life balance. Biggest problems they arise when you carry your heart at your office from home at 9 a.m. and you carry your work in your head at 6 p.m. back home. So don't carry your heart in your office and don't carry your head at your home. Clear demarcation. Home is the place where a heart should work and office is the place where head should work. A little combination of both in a minor percentage at both the places. Majority is this. Relations are from the heart, not from the head. And as a great scientist pastor used to say, the heart has reasons of its own which the head can never understand. The heart has reasons of its own which the head will never understand. So relationships, family values, your personal care, health, your spirit, the onus lies on you.
that is needed. Only then you have maintained a work-life balance. See, even a donkey is working 10, 12, 14 hours. But he doesn't know what it is carrying. Whether on its back it is mud or diamonds, he doesn't know. Sometimes the ship is sailing in the sea, we don't know in which direction it is going. You need to focus, you need to refocus, think and rethink. You can get your work again. Will you get the good raising of your children again in your life? Enjoying the lovable moments of your children getting raised. Will you get it again? If you don't enjoy that, if you haven't enjoyed that, you are not a complete human being. This is all the feedback that we got from the kids and from the elders as well during our seminar at our temple there in New York. So a work-life balance is very much needed. Sorry? Yeah, perfection, that is a work-life balance is properly needed. So that is family life. Even on the personal scale, your health is very important. Once you lose your health, you will be an absolute loser. With all the opportunities right in front of you, if you miss out on health, so take a good sleep. The whole world will revolve around its own axis and rotate around the sun without your permission. Let it rotate and revolve. Okay? And America is not going to decide between Trump and Clinton with your permission. Simple. Modi would not take a different step or a big step with your permission. So be at the place where you are. Don't jump too much. Okay? Even a Paul Volta, Sergey Bubka from Russia, he scaled 6 feet 2 inches. You can't jump over the building. Know your limits. Decide your limits. And remain happy within those circles. You have to put the bar somewhere. If everybody could become Tata, Birla and Ambani, who would work for them? If everybody became Tatas and Ambanis and the Birla, who would work for them? Where would you and me go in the morning? Work-life balance. Your family is equally important, your personal life is equally important, your health is equally important. Lastly, your spirit. We are not this physical body that we see. This is what Lord Krishna tells to Arjuna as well. That you have passed through many births, this is not just one birth. With that knowledge, practically put, you will welcome less stress in your life. The knowledge of Atma and Paramatma. We are the soul. We are not this. This is a perishable human body. This is a 70 or 80 year game. Isn't it? 5, 10 plus minus with the grace of God. Basically, it is a 70 or 80 year game. You have to live it with the perfect sense of living. Otherwise, we will depend at the end of our lives. Again, I suggest a good book. I think this definitely you must read. Write it down. The title of the book is The Five Secrets, the Five Regrets of the Dying. The Five Regrets of the Dying. Likhlo aap sab. I want everybody to write. The title of the book is The Five Regrets of the Dying. Marne walo ka panch paschata. I'm coming to that. You might have read it, so fine. How many of you have read it? Just raise your hands. Like 3-4 of you. The Five Regrets of the Dying, written by a nurse. She was taking care of critically ill patients in a hospital, in a private hospital in Australia. Her name, Bronnie Ware. And she started a blog. The blog went very popular. And then she was advised to write a book. She was not a good writer. She hired a professional writer, and she has written this book. The title of the book is The Five Regrets of the Dying. The Five Regrets of the Dying. Writer is a ladyish brawny hair, B-R-O-N-N-I. She has, what did she do? Is that she used to treat critical ill patients. Even the patients knew that they would pass out in a few days or a couple of days. The relatives and friends of the patients knew, the doctors knew. So secretly, she would ask the patients to fill up a form. And that form was, to the left half was, what at this moment in your life? Because everybody knew that these are the last days of the patient. Even he knew it, the patients knew it. At this moment, what do you cherish in life? And that was point 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. On the right, long half was, what do you regret in your life at this stage? They all wrote, and the range of the people who gave the feedback were from an ordinary carpenter, an ordinary workman, to high-ranking executives, officials, even businessmen, all class of people, all class of working people. And then she writes in this book, the first common regret that came from most of the persons. Most of the persons, the most common regret that came was, the first regret was, why did I work so hard? अगर उसको हिंदी में ट्रांसलेट करें तो मैंने गधे की तरह इतना काम क्यों किया? Why did I work so much? Second regret was, I should have spent more time with my near and dear ones. Now this is not a thinking, this is not an experiment, this is not an assumption, this is not writing a book under the pen, this is a real life survey. Why did I work so much? As I started that start of the talk, do you want to drink the whole sea in your profession? Or agar aap hi gaya tabhi kar paoge? Nahin. Put the bar somewhere. Physical time bar and work bar. Otherwise you will go? You will go? Mad. Body man has written this. A fine book, The Five Regrets of the Dying, you must read. So for the development of the last spirit, I take the last 5 minutes and then we entertain the questions. So the development of the spirit will help you in a proper work-life balance and ethics at work. What is that development of spirit? I think all of you will agree with me when I say that more research has been done in the last 15 years than in 150 years before that. Yes or no? In the last 15 years, principally, 3 fields, they have seen maximum research. More than 70% of the total research are in these 3 fields. First is science and technology. That includes health and everything. Okay? Science and technology. Second is management. And third is social relationships. Of all these 3 fields, of all the researches, if you go deep into it, it all tends towards spirituality. Top management gurus that I named in my first talk, they teach prayers. They teach top class executives to believe in the doership of God. If I talk from under the saffron, you would say, oh, okay, you are a saffron clad person, you are a man of God, and you'll be talking this. But these people, they teach you this. Top health experts, top management experts, top social relationship experts, that is counseling people, they teach you faith. They teach you that you walk by faith. Every step is a faith. We are sitting here happily and listening to me, you all, attentively, without the slightest doubt, even in your subconscious mind, that probably that could be an earthquake and this building might collapse then. Did you have this thought before I told you now? That means you are sitting here with faith. You travel by bus or a car, overnight journey, and you sit, isn't it, in the car?
All of us, we have slept in the car? Yes. Even in the data, the minority. You put the faith in a driver, on a 4,000 rupee driver. Jo tere ko karna hai, wo kar. Main to ye soch. If you could put faith on a 4,000 rupee driver, can't you put faith on God? See, you put faith everywhere, but when it comes to faith in God, you produce thousands of thoughts. But He is the all-doer. That will develop your spirit to an extent that you will never feel depressed, tensed, or low. See, I don't hold a bank account. I've been talking this since 24 years that I took Diksha. I took Diksha in 1992 after my graduation. I've been talking since last 23 years. I don't charge a single penny for my talk. Kushil ji, bolna. That's a good one. I don't charge a single penny for money. It's my just humble social service. Inspiring people with good and ethical thoughts and behaviors. I don't have a bank account, I don't have a wife, I don't have children, I don't have a house, I don't have a bank account, I don't wear ornaments in the same clothes, the same time, and the same color I've been wearing since 24 years. And my new Brahma Swami since 78 years. Can you see something tense or on my face? This is my 24/7, this is 60/80 life, huh? You got it, what I said? 24/7, 365/80. You have 24/7 shops? This is 24 hours, 7 days a week, 365 days in a year, and 80 years of your life. So when I take a whole day work life seminar, I say this, what I explain in detail, 24/7, 365/80. I point this term to properly explain the work-life balance, what I said now. People serve 24/7. You must think of 24/7, 365/80. That will develop your spirit, that faith. And now it is logically, scientifically proved that God exists and God is the all-doer. As I said, management, health, science and technology, everything is proving this now. I was talking to about 400 scientists at Bandra, at Taj Lands. My topic was logic versus faith. At the end of the session, a gentleman, a scientist, he raised a question, said, Swami, can you give me a logical faith in the existence of God? I said, yes. He said, how? I said, forget, I can show you now. He said, what? I said, yes. I'm asking you, do you want to see God? Tell me yes or no. Yes, then raise your hands. Okay. When?
Right now.
When? Okay, now? Ready? Enthusiastic one. I said, it was daytime, I said, just open the window and peep out. There is sun, God. Okay, the scriptures have said, Surya Devata, sun, God, okay, fine. Logically, it is right. I just put a simple question to these 400 scientists, that if for some reason, the sun goes on a 2-day tour. It doesn't rise tomorrow morning. As we used to do in the algebra, suppose x is not equal to y. At the end of the theorem, we prove x is equal to y, so this is this, isn't it? Let's start with this writer. If suppose the sun doesn't arise tomorrow, then you all the scientists of NASA, European Space Agency, and ISRO, can you come together to make the sun rise? Secondly, do you have the alternate to the sun? If you start burning all the things that can be burned upon this earth, all coal and cloths and paper and wood and everything, can you make the morning fall? Yes or no? You cannot. Morning will fall only when it rises from 13 crore miles away from earth. So the first characteristic of God is power. This is power, absolute power. No alternate to the sun. And you know, recently NASA, National Aeronautics and Space Association, Jitu Mehta, one of my very good friends, Jitu Mehta is a very senior scientist. More than 300 scientists work under him. And he was the designer of the remote sensing devices that for the unmanned mission on Mars. First by, and he was felicitated in the White House. A very good friend of mine. And he said, and then I asked him, this about this particular theory. He said, Swami, there is no alternate to it. If it doesn't rise, what is the alternate? Can all the scientists you work together to make it rise? No. That is absolute power. First characteristic of God is power. Second characteristic is love. Because of the heat, the flora and the fauna upon this earth exists. Isn't it? Because of the heat of the sun. Even if it is 44 degrees, I think you caught the terms. Do you experience 44?
Yes.
At times, do you?
Yes.
Sorry?
Yes.
Feels like 44 because you wear a coat. Simple. I think Kolkata maximum temperature is
48.
42, 43. Okay. Then you are experiencing what you experience in Gujarat. If for some reason, you know, there NASA people discovered that 60,000 crore tons of gas transformation happens every second on the surface of sun, and that is why this shine and this heat. Give me the number of zeros in your chart accountants. 60,000 crore tons. Give me the number of zeros behind 6. Quick. You are telling the queen. Your treasurer, the chief among you, pehle 12 bole, phir 13 bole. So, ye ye ghus pe pad gaye, aap kya karoge? Every second. Now, give me the amount of gas that got transformed since the time we started talking about sun. All CS combined, come on. It's beyond your scan of intelligence. It's beyond our scan of intelligence. Not patient. Who is controlling that? Then I ask the second question to this 400 scientists. Gravitational pull keeps everybody on the ground. Even when one person was walking upon this earth, he was able to walk lightly. And now we 7 billion, we are able to walk comfortably. So, ek vyakti ke liye bhi gravitation proper tha, aur 7 billion ke liye bhi gravitation proper hai. Does it happen somewhere that you go on the other side of Havra and then your legs go 2 feet inside the ground because there is gravitation for more, and on the eastern side of Havra there is less, and you start flying 1 feet above the ground? Aisa kuch ho raha hai? दुनिया में कभी भी हो रहा है, कहीं भी हो रहा है, इक्वल ग्रेविटेशनल पुल ऑन द एंटायर सरफेस, इवन व्हेन वन पर्सन वाज एडजस्टिंग, इवन 7 मिलियन, हु इज एडजस्टिंग दैट ग्रेविटेशनल पुल? एंड आई आस्क द साइंटिस्ट, यू हैव नेम्ड दिस फोर्स एज ग्रेविटेशन, कैन यू टेल मी एनीबॉडी ऑफ यू वेयर डज इट कम फ्रॉम, और इफ इट इज गेटिंग यूज, यस और नो? हाफ ऑफ देम आर लाइक यस नो, बिकॉज़ इफ आई शेक हैंड विद यू, इफ आई पुल यू टुवर्ड्स मी, आई एम यूटिलाइजिंग सम एनर्जी. Isn't it? Energy is getting used. Yes or no?
Yes.
Then gravitational pull, lot of energy getting used. If is it getting created again? Stunned silence. And if it is getting created again, regenerated, who is doing it in the right proportion? रोज रात को 12 बजे कौन डिसाइड कर रहा है कि आज इतना ग्रेविटेशन पुल यूज होगा तो इतना रिजेनरेट करो? There is a decider. Many things, topic apart, believe. You walk like it. Every step is faith. I can give you 100 names of top class scientists, from Albert Einstein to Isaac Newton to Archimedes to Pascal, even Stephen Hawking, staunch believers in God. Those scientists who have scaled a certain height in their respective fields of science, they have come to know that He is there and He exists. And they have written. ये हम लोग विद अ नॉट अ फुल नॉलेज ऑफ साइंस, दिस भगवान है कि नहीं, आई एम अ सेक्युलर माइंड सेट, दिस एंड दैट, ओके, वी आर आल्सो अ गुड माइंड सेट, बिलीव द साइंटिस्ट ऑफ बिलीव. आइजैक न्यूटन का नाम सुना है एवरीबॉडी ऑफ अस? ही हैज मोर देन 150 डिस्कवरीज एंड इन्वेंशंस टू हिज नेम. ही वाज वंस सिटिंग इन हिज बैकयार्ड. And he was just casually having a cup of coffee with his wife. And looked at his thumb and just started having the different movements of thumb. And he could count more than about 12 movements of his thumb.
Different.
We know only one movement. He knew 10. The man who gave the laws of motion, he writes in his autobiography, again, letter to letter. I'll quote it. He writes that in the absence of any other proof, the movement of this thumb alone convinces me of God's existence.